The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 16, verses 9 to 15. Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you this, use money, tainted as it is, to win your friends, and thus make sure that when it fails you, they will welcome you into the tents of eternity. The man who can be trusted in little things can be trusted in great. The man who is dishonest in little things will be dishonest in great. If then you cannot be trusted with money, that tainted thing, who will trust you with genuine riches? And if you cannot be trusted with what is not yours, who will give you what is your very own? No servant can be the slave of two masters. He will either hate the first and love the second, or treat the first with respect and the second with scorn. You cannot be the slave both of God and of money. The Pharisees, who loved money, heard all this and laughed at him. He said to them, You are the very ones who pass yourselves off as virtuous in people's sight. But God knows your hearts, for what is thought highly of by men is loathsome in the sight of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, money is very important in our lives. We can't do anything without money. People need money in their homes. People need money in the churches. People need money in their business place. People need money for everything in life. Even if you need to buy a Bible, you need money. My dear brothers and sisters, money is not important to make eternal life, but you can use money to do so. The reading of today from Luke chapter 16, verse 9 to 15, is self-explanatory. It is very easy to understand what Jesus is trying to say. If you and me cannot be trusted in money, which is a tainted thing, it has no value in itself for eternal life. But you use it to gain friends who will give you a way to eternal life, who will welcome you when it fails you, when money fails you, the tainted thing fails you, they will welcome you. Jesus is trying to tell us through the life of the Pharisees, some of them who totally depended on money and used money for bad things. You know, when in our country elections, different parties will give different items to people. Some even give money. This is a tainted thing, used either for good or for bad. People give money, and this money keeps circulating during the election times. A lot of money. And people get carried away by this act. And people want to get more. And then They vote for someone who gives more. Whether they vote for him or her, we do not know, but they like to receive from people. So this becomes a routine in our life. This becomes a necessity in our life. Though we need money for everything, how do we use money? And for what purpose do we use money? That is very important thing. We cannot serve both masters at the same time. You cannot serve God, you cannot serve money at the same time. You cannot serve God and world at the same time. Because in the bargain, you will love one and hate the other. My dear friends, Jesus says to us today, if you cannot be trusted in something that is not yours, how will God trust you and give you something that is your own? It is very difficult. If you cannot be trusted in small things of this world, how can he hand over to you great things about the heavenly things? These statements are very inspirational for us today. What do we seek for in our day-to-day lives? Let us look into our own lives today. If we are doing spiritual activities for you, and gradually when we begin to get money and we get all that we need, gradually love for spiritual activities will disappear for some. Because their mind is on money. They may be thinking they are doing God's work, and people will be thinking, oh, this is a wonderful work. But sometimes it is only to acquire money. And when the money is come, my work is done. I care a hang with God, who God is and who the people of God are. The person who loves God will persevere in his efforts to serve him, whatever may be the matter. When a poor man, if he begins to get more money gradually, if he is not a grateful man, he will begin to feel proud of himself gradually. I achieved everything at my own accord. I became big. I am more important. And gradually, that God is gone from our lives and material things have taken up everything in us. All that we get, we use to buy material things for ourselves. And as we get up, we find joy in looking at things which are around us. And we gradually forget God who is in our lives. A man who is ungrateful to God will be such type of a person who works for God days in and days out, but finally gives up because when he has earned money, his purpose of serving God is over. So, my dear friends, you as lay people or religious or priests, and me as a priest, need to reflect on this. Jesus is asking us this question. Even if I am a priest, is money important for me or God or the people of God? Is my ministry important towards my people, or all that I acquire that is important? Jesus clearly mentions to us, people who do not belong to the kingdom of God will prove themselves when the tainted thing is in their hand, that is money. The importance of the prodigal son, when he gets money in his hand, he becomes satanic. He goes out, meals out, remains with friends. He's not worried about his family. He goes out, he thinks that he will get many more friends, lot of joy outside. So he spends all the money. But the time will come when this money will be over. And then you will look to God. So my dear friends, let us not wait for that particular instance, but let us serve the Lord with total holiness, without concentrating much on money, but concentrating on the necessities of the kingdom of God. Amen.